Welcome to our channel Right Click Education. In this video we will learn how we can implement Angular Material Divider in our application. So mat divider is basically used whenever you want to separate different elements in your page. Okay, so without getting delayed, let's get straight back to the visual and implementation. So open Angular Material, open your Chrome, type Angular Material, your browser, search it, open this material.angular.io, which is the official website of Angular Material. Then click on this component. You can see in the side navbar there are a lot of different Angular Material elements. Today we will learn about divider. So click on it. So if you see, right, we have item 1, item 2 and item 3, and after item 1 you can see a horizontal line is here. Okay, so this is a simple divider which is separating item 1 from item 2. Then also we have again one divider which separates item 2 from item 3. Okay, so this is the simple implementation of mat divider. Okay, so let's go and implement it. For that, click on API, copy this import, go to your VS Code, go to your app.model.ts, simply paste it here, copy this mat divider module. In the ng module and in the import section of ng module, paste this mat divider module. Okay, so you can see in the ng module we have this import section. Under that you need to paste mat divider module. Okay, so now we have done with the import part. Now let's implement the HTML also. So click on overview. First we will implement this simple divider. Okay, click on this view code, copy this. So what we have done, we have taken a mat list, okay, and then we have put after every element or item we have put a divider. Okay, let's go to app.component.html, paste it here. So you can see, right, what we have done, we have taken a list and after each item we have put this mat divider. So it will basically divide one item from another. Okay, now let's see. Go to your localhost 4200. So it's saying mat list is not known element. Okay, so the problem is we haven't imported mat list. That's why this issue we are getting. So we will click on, if you see here in the side nav, we have this list. The list import is missing, so we will copy this mat list module. Okay, go to your app.model.ts, paste it, copy this mat list module. Under the ng module and import section, paste this import here. Okay, now go to your localhost 4200. You can see that we have this list of items and after every item we have this divider, right? You can see a thin line, right? So this is the divider that we have implemented. Now let us talk about some of the properties that we can use with the divider according to our need. Okay, so we have this inset property. So let's copy this and try to use it in our application. Okay, so we have made this inset as true. For another divider, we will make it as false. Okay, so that we can see how it works for both true and false case. Right, let's go to our UI. Let's see. You can see, right? So if I have done inset equals to true, it has been shifted little bit of right, and by default that is false, so the line has started from here, right? So this is one use of inset property with MatDivider. Now we can use a property that is vertical, so let's also copy this vertical. Let's remove this inset, paste it here. Okay, and let's also make it vertical. Okay, now let's go. So you can see, right, since this item one is vertical, you cannot see any divider. Okay, so let's make this one also true. Right, now let's see. You can see there is no divider here, right, because it's vertical, so you cannot see the horizontal divider, right? Let's go to the official website. So whatever we have seen, I will just give a brief summary. So MatDivider is used to separate one item from another item. So in order to divide the items, you can use MatDivider after every item. We have two properties that we can use with MatDivider. One is inset. So if you use inset equals to true, the horizontal line, that is, let's make it false. So this horizontal line, if you make inset as true, it will be shifted a little bit of right, and if you make it as false, it will look as it is looking right now. And second property we can use with it is vertical. So when you use vertical, it will remove this horizontal divider. Okay, so in this way we can implement MatDivider in Angular Material. That's it for this video. If you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe the channel and press on the bell icon to get more updates. Thanks and have a nice day.